ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nizaruddin bin Muhammad. Today we are here to discuss the topic of whether social media bring more harm than benefit. As the first speaker for the affirmative team, I firmly support the idea that social media does, in fact, bring more harm than good. First, let's define our terms. Social media refers to a platform that allows users to create, share, and engage with content. Harm encompasses the negative physical and emotional impact, while benefits are the positive outcome derived from an action or situation. We argue that the negative effect of social media significantly outweigh is positive. My first point is about mental health. Research show a disturbing link between social media use and mental health issue, particularly among young people. A study by the Royal Society for Public Health from the platform like Instagram and Snapchat associated with increased level of anxiety, depression, and body image issue. The constant comparison to idealize portrayals of other life creates unrealistic expectation and foster feeling of inadequacy. In conclusion, social media contributes to significant mental health challenges. Make it clear that the harm outweigh any perceived benefit. Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Muhammad Rehman. As the leader of the opposition, today we are here to discuss whether social media bring more harm than benefit. As the first speaker for the opposition team, I strongly oppose this statement and argue that social media provides significant benefit that outweigh its potential harm. First, let's refer our terms. Social media refers to digital platform that enable user to create, share, and engage with the content. Harm composes negative impact on individual and society, will benefit the positive outcomes that arise from social media. My first point is about connectivity. Social media allows people to stay connected regardless of geographical barrier. For instance, families inspired by distance can easily share updates and maintain relationships to platforms like Facebook and WhatsApp. Additionally, social media serves as a vital tool for marginalized communities, giving them a voice and enabling them to organize for social change. Movements like hashtag Black Lives Matter and hashtag Me Too gains momentum towards social media, demonstrating its power to drive social progress. In conclusion, social media plays a crucial role in enhancing connectivity and fostering community engagement, proving that its benefit of the harm. And thank you.
Thank you, Speaker One. Good morning again, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Jajan as the second speaker for the affirmative team. I will further elaborate on the harmful impact of social media, focusing on misinformation and privacy concerns. First, let's discuss misinformation and fake news. Social media platforms have become breeding grounds for false information, which can mislead public opinion and create confusion. During such as health, Emergencies, misinformation can spread rapidly, undermining trust in credible source and leading to harmful behavior. For example, false claims about vaccines shared on social media can deter individuals from getting vaccinated in the endangering public health. Next, I want to address privacy concerns. Users often share personal information without fully understanding the implications. Privacy breach and data misuse have become alarmingly common. A report from the Pew Research Center found that 64 of Americans have experienced a data breach. This not only poses risk of identity theft, but also leads to a general sense of insecurity among users, who worry about their information being exploited. In summary, the spread of misinformation and serious privacy issue highlight the detrimental effect of social media. These factors clearly demonstrate that social media brings more harm than benefits. Thank you.
Thank you, speaker 2.
Good morning again, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Muhammad Azharawi, the Deputy Leader of the Opposite. As the second speaker for the opposition team, I will elaborate on the key benefit of social media, focusing on information dissemination and educational opportunities. First, let's discuss the role of social media in dissemination information. Social media serve as a primary source of news and update, particularly in time of crisis. During natural disasters or emergencies, platforms like Twitter can provide real-time information that is vital for public safety. This rapid dissemination of information can save lives and keep communities informed. Additionally, social media provide a world of educational resource. Many platforms offer access to expert knowledge, tutorial and skill building opportunities. For example, platforms like YouTube and LinkedIn Learning allow users to enhance their skill and process lifelong learning. Furthermore, educators are intentionally using social media to engage students and create collaborative learning environment, demonstrating its potential as a powerful educational tool. In summary, social media facilitates critical information sharing and offer vast educational resources, reinforcing the argument that its benefit far outweigh and potential harm. Thank you.
Thank you, speaker 2. Good morning or foremost, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Rahmat, as the title speaker of the committee team. I will summarize our arguments and reinforce why social media brings more harm than benefits. We have discussed the significant mental health issues caused by social media, including anxiety, depression, and low self-esteem among young people. Additionally, we have highlighted the rampant misinformation and privacy concerns the platform. Now, Let's consider the societal implications social media can contribute to polarization and division. Online echo chambers reinforce extreme viewpoints and discourage healthy debate. This can lead to social fragmentation where individuals are less willing to engage with differing opinions. However, the addictive nature of social media can lead to decreased productivity and empirical life relationship. People may prioritize online interaction over face-to-face communication, diminishing the quality of their personal connection. In conclusion, while social media may offer some benefits, such as connectivity and information sharing, the overwhelming evidence points to its harmful effect on mental health. The spread of misinformation, privacy violation, and social division. Therefore, we firmly believe that social media brings more harm than benefit. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, speaker two. Good morning once more, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ivan Ray, as the third speaker for the opposition team. I will summarize our arguments and reinforce why social media does not bring more harm than benefits. We have highlighted the significant advantage of social media, including enhanced connectivity, the ability to foster social movement, and its role in disseminating important information. Additionally, we discussed the educational opportunities that social media provide, empowering users to learn and grow. While it's important to acknowledge the potential harm of social media, such as mental health concerns and misinformation, we argue that this issue can be addressed through education, digital literacy, and responsible usage rather than abandoning the platform altogether. Promoting awareness about online behavior and the importance of fact-checking can help mitigate the negative effect while still enjoying the benefits. Moreover, social media has become an integral part of modern society, increasing business, culture, and communication. It has transformed how we interact and engage with the world around us, creating opportunities that did not exist before. In conclusion, while social media does pose challenge, the myriad benefit it offers, such as connectivity, access to information, and educational opportunities, clearly demonstrate that it brings more benefits than harm. Thank you for your attention.